And we're away now in the start of the Visitors Challenge Cup, Oxford Brookes University B against the team from France, Lyon and Grenoble.
Yes, Brookes there on the left-hand side in that maroon, white and blue. Just getting off nice and cleanly, and quite a good start already off the French crew, so Lyon and Grenoble. This is the French crew on the right-hand side is actually a combination of four clubs, believe it or not. We've got Lyon, Grenoble, and then we've got two from Paris, so CNF and ACBB. So four clubs all in there, but actually they're just all four mates. I think they've got a bit of a WhatsApp group going around in France where they all sort of plug in and they're just like, right, I fancy a row at Henley, let's go and give it a go. And they admitted that it's been difficult getting out in the boat and you know, you're up against a good Brookes crew here. You know, Brookes are no slouches when it comes to rowing at Henley, and they look pretty slick here. Brookes have taken quite an early lead.
Yeah, look, we can see this French crew on screen. They're really giving it some, but struggling with those bouncy conditions. You can see a bit of boat wash coming through. I mean, that's tough for any crew to handle, but really finding that pretty tough going. But Brookes looking pretty calm, opening up to a very comfortable lead. And we'll move up to the Fawley marker now and see how this race is panning out. And just like it was starting to look down in the start there, it is the crew from Oxford Brookes University B who has a very commanding lead at this still early stage of the race. But I think they've shut this down early. They've taken command. They're looking pretty chilled out.
They do, don't they? I mean, off the start, it was looking like they were taking a foot every sort of stroke. And actually, they've just opened and keep opening that distance out down the course, although now it does look like they've sort of just slipped it into a sort of cruising gear a little bit. Peter Chambers there in the bow seat, an ex international lightweight who has retired from international lightweight rowing this year, but still loves the sport no end, is in that boat there having a great time racing at Henley with his mates from Oxford Brookes. I used to race with Peter, great guy, great racer, and he's there in the bow seat probably giving them all the experience and wisdom that he's had from racing in the lightweight fours. You know, he was a lightweight Olympic silver medalist at London 2012, so a very accomplished oarsman there, guiding that crew from Oxford Brookes down the course. Just a little bit worried for the Oxford Brookes boat as we come past a little bit of debris, but I think they've cleared it pretty comfortably under their stroke side rigger, so nothing to worry about there.
Yes, we see the French crew on screen there. Sort of in the mid-20s, 25, 27, 26 years of age. Coming in just a little heavier than the crew from Oxford Brookes. They're about 88 kilos, the crew average of the French crew, so they're big, strong rowers. But the lighter men from Oxford Brookes, so we can see them from behind there looking very skillful. We can see there Peter Chambers looking around. You've still got a little while to go, mate.
Yeah, I think they've enjoy Henley. This is a great trip down the course for them. The French crew on our left-hand side, they're still racing along. I mean, these guys were really just pretty pumped up to be here. They love coming to Henley. The experience, they say, the English culture when it comes to Henley is something very unique to rowing, and that's what they've come over here for, it to be a part of. I know they were teaching me some phrases. They were saying that one of their phrases, which I can't repeat in French, my French is terrible, but they were saying a key one for them was like, row long, push hard, which I think is like standard, you know, it's like rowing gospel, isn't it? It's one of those things that is always used across any language, and that's what they'll be trying to do in that boat now. They're still racing, both boats are still racing, but, you know, in the left-hand side there, that French crew, they are pushing it along and trying to get back on terms with Oxford Brookes on the right-hand side of the screen there.
Yeah, so this crew from France, they're no slouches. Galay and Nouri are both former members of the French under-23 team, so some international racing pedigree in that boat, but they're finding the challenge from Oxford Brookes a little bit tough. And as you say, Adam, if they've only recently come together, the four is a pretty difficult sort of boat to get together. And
looks like they've got their mascot with them there. Is that a small little cat toy or something?
It's definitely like a Pokemon or something.
Yeah, it does, maybe a little Pokemon. Yeah, it reminds me of my travels around India where you would see people would emblazon their taxis or tuk-tuks with all sorts of goodwill sort of mementos, or religious mementos as well. Like, but there you go, Brookes taking the lead there.
Yeah, we'd expect this crew. They raced at Marlow. They won the gold by 4 seconds ahead of the visitors' entry from the University of British Columbia. And certainly with the pedigree of Pete Chambers steering from the bow seat there, I think we expected to probably see them put in a good showing, but the French taking it all the way down to the line. but they're not going to be able to be a challenge for Oxford Brookes University B, who will move through to Friday in the Visitors Challenge Cup. And there we have it. Oxford Brookes University beats the team from France.